Now we are going to build a simple database query builder like Laravel. Here I only have an index.php file, and I have a database called example with a table called users, and I have 4 users here. At the end, I would like to be able to run something like this: db table users select id and name, where name is John or where name is Mary, and then get. If you are familiar with object-oriented programming, this is actually pretty straightforward. It's a combination of static methods, chaining functionalities, and one magic method. That's it. So let's build it together. DB double colon is static. If you are not familiar with static methods, watch my other video where I explain static methods. At the end, we will change it to static, but for now, let's change it to a normal object. Let's define the object. I like my class to be called database, but you can call yours anything you want. And let's define our class. The first thing is that we need to get connected to database. I don't like the connecting to database to be part of this class, so I would like to pass a PDO object to it. So let's use construct method to pass the PDO object. And let's add the PDO before I forget. Now let's define the PDO and connection to database. If you don't know how to get connected to database, watch my other video where I talk about everything you need to know about databases. We need to have DSN, which is a type of database, host, and the database itself. We need to have the user and the password, and then we pass these to our PDO and get connected to database. We can also pass some extra option like error mode and things like that. So let's create the first method for table and define the table variable. By returning this, which is referring to the object itself, we are making these chaining methods. If you want to know more about chaining methods, watch my other video. Now let's do the next one, which is select. We want to get the fields that we would like to select, but if it wasn't specified, we want to select everything. So we can set the default value of the fields to a star. And next we want to add where. This is a bit tricky because user can call where multiple times. To be able to handle it, we can have a variable called where, which is an array. And every time we call where method, it could add to that array. Later we will handle that array. Each where clause is 3 parts: the column, the operator, and the value. For where, we are going to have AND as default. For our OR where method, we are going to duplicate the where method and change it to OR. But the rest of the things that is going to add to our where array is going to be the same structure. Now let's create the get method where everything comes together. We want to select the fields from this table, and rather than running raw queries, it's always better to prepare the statement and then execute it. And let's check if the where array is not empty. Then we have to include that where clause as well. All the items in the where array has a type which was AND or. But for the first one, we are not going to include it. So we should check and only use it if the index is not 0. And instead of value, we are going to add question mark and then pass the value as binded values. Here we want to pass all the values from our items in where array. We can use for each, but the cleaner way is to use a building function called array column, which is super useful in our case. We specify which column we want in which array, and it gets all the values that have the same key that we have specified. In our case, the keys are called value. It will give us the values all together, and we can pass that to execute method as binded values for all the question marks that we have added. And then get the data as object and return it. That's it, that should do it. So let's loop through our users and echo them. Now the moment of truth. Let's call phpindex.php file and see if it works. Perfect, it works. And if we remove the where part, I expect to get everything. And yes, great. Now we are not finished yet. Now I want to change a DB variable and be able to use it like I initially wanted. So let's do it. Let's create a class called DB, and let's create an instance variable, and let's create a method that would get that instance. So what is this instance? The instance is a database class that we have created so far. All we are doing here is that we want to make sure we are not creating multiple objects. We want to make sure we will only have one instance. And now here is the magic method that I told you about. What we are going to do is to check what method is being called on the DB class and then call the same method on the database class, which we have an instance of. So first we need to get that instance, which if it's null, it will create new one. Then we are using the built-in PHP function called user function array, and we are telling it to call this method of this instance and pass these arguments. That's it. That's where all the magic happens. And let's bring the PDO connection here as well. Now when I call DB table, it first check if we have an instance or not, then it will create and call the table method of that database class with the argument which was the table name. It does that to all the methods. Let's change back our DB to the static function that we created and let's call it. Perfect, it works. If we comment out where, it would give me all of the users, and if I only keep one of the where methods, it gives me that user. Perfect. As for your practice, you can add other methods like order by, join, limit, offset to our database class, which is our main query builder. Enjoy coding!